Chapter 12, Carrying On Gandhi's Message. The heart's earnest and pure desire is always fulfilled. Before he was a grown-up called a Mahatma, before he led a nonviolent movement for a more fair South Africa and a free India, Gandhi was a child who, like yourself, wanted to live in peace, security, and happiness. So he went on a search for truth. When he found it, he learned that it lives in his own heart, as well as in the heart of each and every one of us. Gandhi never forgot that his search for truth began when he was a little boy, and he knew how wise and special children are. He cared very deeply for children all around the world. This is why he chose nonviolence. He did not want to see children learn violence or be harmed by it. He wanted all children and grown-ups to learn how to practice nonviolence. He even said that nonviolence can best be learned not from grown-ups, but from children, like yourself. In fact, when he met the great Italian peace educator, Maria Montessori, he said, "If we want peace in the world, we will have to begin with the children." Nonviolence is hard work. It takes a lot of time and a lot of practice. At the end of Gandhi's life, he was still learning about its power. We have to practice with our families, our friends, our schoolmates, and even those who don't like us. We will make mistakes, but we can try again and let others try again when they make mistakes. We are trying to learn to love everyone unconditionally because we all have dignity. Gandhi's search for truth transformed him and the world we live in. He had no doubt that all of us could do the same, as long as we bring to this challenge the same dedication and devotion that he did. If we want to help everyone, and if we want to end violence, we can also become Mahatmas who can benefit the whole world.